Hello, it's me again, and I am here with my incubator, my magnifying glass with a light on it. Ooh, that's pretty clear through there. Let's see how we... And my handy-dandy, sorry I get off subject, flashlight with an adjustable beam. Now, I got this off of eBay. It's pretty goat. Pretty great, but anyway, it projects onto the wall, but when you're up close, it makes a real fine point little dot. So what we're going to be doing today is a more extensive egg candling video. Now first, I want to tell you about my incubator and how I hatch my eggs. Now there's a million different ways to do it, but it's not as complicated as everybody makes it out to be. Everybody makes it out to be real complicated. First thing you gotta do is you gotta have good, fresh, viable eggs. Second thing, don't wash them. If you're gonna incubate them, don't worry about washing them. If your eggs look like that right there, then you need to put new straw. I'm hatching these for somebody else, but you need to put like more straw or let the hens, there's too many hens in the nest there. Now these, they've not been washed, I don't think. I know these two have not, because I just put them in here to keep them warm for a few minutes. But anyway, we're going to set this camera down up here, and I'm going to tell you about the eggs. Oh, and I've got a goose down feather blanket that the dogs ripped a hole in. I'm going to patch it with silicone later. Y'all look up how to patch things with silicone. But anyway, I keep it over the top and a blanket over the top of my incubator, sitting on top of my Black & Decker. Now this one, I was hatching great, and I didn't have a turner in it. Now if you want to turn your eggs every day without a turner, if you don't have a turner, then what I reckon, sorry, I'm having to hold this. I'm about to set it down so that Tina can watch it without all her, without all my shaking going on. I do think about that, but I just don't. But anyway, I was using this one. Oh, I was gonna tell y'all how to turn 100 eggs. See, if I pack this full in egg cartons, where's my egg cartons? Or, you know, you can put a nest box in there like this right here. Now, what you're gonna wanna do is you get your incubator on, you get your temperature right, get your humidity between 40 and 60 degrees. I mean, degrees. But anyway, when you want to turn your eggs, all you got to do is take and put a piece of bamboo under your refrigerator there in the middle. And then when you check on your eggs in the morning, turn them that way. When you check on your eggs at night, you turn them this way. About once every week or so, you know, go in there when you candle them. Turn them about. Let me set this down. I've done told you all I need to tell you there. Now, I did do something a little different. I got a computer fan and put in my dry incubator, because I don't like just a dry still air. I like it to flow pretty good. And we're going to go ahead and candle these eggs now. I'm sorry this is taking so long. I'm going to set this down right here. Turn the camera around. And yeah, that's a new feature I just figured out. I turn my camera around, it's pretty ridiculous. So I'm gonna turn this dope so y'all don't have to see my face too much. And the first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna candle my two eggs that I just brought in today from the hen, and I'm gonna talk to you about them, about my hen. She's not gone broody, she's free range. So I found her nest, and this is what the egg looks like. Now I like to put my hand on there like this, because you can control the light a little bit better. You turn it. But anyway, we're gonna check. You can check and see if it's, sometimes you can tell if it's viable, if it's a good clear egg. But I know these are viable because George is out there fighting with Henry, and Henry's fighting with George, just trying to make sure. Now this on the end here, well, see if I can, y'all can't see the air pocket in there very well because it's too much light. Sometimes you got too much light, But this one, they're laid, they have almost no air pocket. So their humidity's good, everything's good about them. I brought them in here just to make sure and keep them a little bit on the warm side, and I'll turn them every day or two when I check my eggs. Now, we're gonna start out with the duck egg. Now, a duck egg and a guinea egg takes close to 28 days. We threw the other duck egg away. Now, right here, on, see if you can see the, right there you can see the air pocket. So it's got plenty of room to breathe. That means your humidity is right. If your air pocket gets too big, increase your humidity. If your air pocket gets too low, too small, you got too much humidity. And this is really close. Now, I don't always have a hickey. Now, that one, it's going to hatch 10 days after these chicken eggs do, because it takes like 21 days, so it's going to take about a week longer. All right, chicken egg, you got a good one right there. And now, I don't know if this one's viable or not, so I'm going to put it up towards the front of my incubator because I know I've got to do it. Now, I'm going to reach back here in the back. Well, I'm going to reach up here at front and see what this one is. This one's a dark egg. It's got a real good air pocket. And I honestly can't see through that shell. That one's getting some good minerals. So we're going to just assume that since the air pocket's balanced, that it's good. I'm gonna put it like on the second row of the tray because I don't know for sure if it's good. And then we're gonna check this one. This one is really hard to candle as well. And I'm sorry about the grainy video. It happens when you're in the dark. But anyway, that one looks decent. We're gonna put it on the second row as well. I don't have any idea how good it is, but then we're going to candle this egg. This one, it looks like it might be good. We're going to keep it. Put it on the second row. It's not definite. Now this one that is definitely good, well, that's the second row too. I'll find one in a minute that's 100% definitely a good one, and every one of them is going to form a little different. Now that one's doing the same thing there. If anybody knows more than I do, teach me, because I'm not perfect. Now this one, I have no idea. This one here, it's got that, you know, oh, it's definitely 100% good, because on top of see if I can get this back and get it to focus. I hate this front camera on this iPhone. You see that right there? Now, that one's the first one we're going to put in the top one closest to me, because I know 100% that this one is a really good viable egg. Let's see if I can. I'm going to switch to the other camera and let y'all see it better. All right, guys, y'all settle down. Hear me? Y'all just settle down. Let's get back over here to our egg here and see what we can. I don't know if y'all seen those veins yet or not. This is a terrible setup. If I had somebody to hold my camera, I guess I might do a little bit better. Anyway, we'll just do more information and less visuals on this. Like I said, I'm putting it in the front right tray of my incubator, because I'm 99.9% sure that one's going to hatch. So here we're going to go on to this next one. It's got that little weird ring. I don't know if that one's going to survive or not, but it probably will. So I'm going to put it on the second row. and I'm gonna just go through. That's got that weird ring. So it's probably a good egg. This one's too dark, but it looks like it's going good. All these up here have the ring. I'm gonna pull some of these from the back here. There's my duck egg. I know it's good. I'm gonna put it up front next to this chicken egg. I could tell them apart. Now, when you're trying to tell the duck egg from a chicken egg, duck eggs are really smooth, almost waxy coated, and chicken eggs seem to be more porous. So, and a duck egg will be more hydrophobic. And I learned the word for the opposite of hydrophobic. What's the opposite of hydro, y'all? Y'all tell me in the comments. But anyway, that egg's good. Now be careful and don't drop them or shake them. It's okay to turn them around as many times as you want to turn them around, because they get that business with a hen and everything. If I find another really good one, I ain't gonna do no more of them real dark ones, because you can't see much in a dark egg. Alright. Well, anyway, these are just like a week along, so I'm gonna try them again in a few days. Probably won't torture y'all with it, but if you've got any questions and want me to do any other videos, you know, with it or anything like that, just let me know and I'll see what I can do. Hey, I almost look like one of the aliens from I Love Lucy, my favorite episode. Are you from Mars? Yeah, I'm from Mars. Bye-bye now. See y'all later. Actually, I'm from Venus, but that was another life. See y'all later.